What would I do if my roommate was gay?
Well, if my roommate was gay, I will try to interact with him. You know, just hang out and get to know him better. Because I don't see nothing wrong or different if he has different preferences as I do. I will just try to get along with him.
If my roommate's gay, my roommate's gay. So, more power to you. If anything, I'll just try to be your wing woman. Like, I don't see it as a big deal.
It's a lot different, like, to like know like a person's gay and then like to like live with them, and to like, I guess it wouldn't really matter until like he brings a guy over and then you see him like making out.
Honestly, it wouldn't bother me too much. I mean, I've got an aunt who is gay, and it's just always been a part of my life, and it's not one of those weird things that's not talked about in my household. So I feel like it wouldn't be a problem. I would be very open to it, because I mean, everyone's a different person, and everybody has their own personality and what they like, and I think that's what's great about people.
I don't really think I would do anything differently than I do now. I mean, it's just a preference, I guess you could say, but I would try to make it clear that I'm not a part of that.
I did have a homosexual roommate, and he was a cool dude. He did his thing, I did my thing. It's all good. Yeah. There would be times where he would dress up like a woman. Personally, I thought, like, pretty impressive, really. You know, like, he could have fooled me pretty easily. I also state that I didn't really connect with him that much, because, like, not including the sexual orientation stuff, it's just like we didn't have a whole lot in common.
My name is Taylor. I'm from Brandon, Florida, and I go to the University of Tampa.
If I were to describe Taylor, I'd say she's very open. She really likes to do stuff, and she's very nice in certain ways.
She's very open, that's for sure. Like, physically, emotionally, everything, sexually.
She's very outgoing. Like, she's not the kind of girl, like, she doesn't care, like, what, like, if she will go up to you and be like, yeah, I'm gay, or yeah, that's my girlfriend. Like, she's not very, like, she doesn't hide it, and, like, that's what I love about her.
I would describe myself as pretty girly, outgoing, confident, and athletic. My roommates acted the way that I thought they would, because nowadays, no one really cares. Like, I haven't really come across anyone that was like, oh, I'm not gonna be your friend because you're gay. So basically, like, coming into these people that don't really know me, I feel like they were still obligated to, even if they weren't okay with it, to act like they were okay with it, considering I just met them, and it'd be kind of rude to, like, straight up, like, not be okay with it. But if down the road they told me that they weren't, then maybe I would understand. But I still have yet in 4 years come by someone that's really, like, come up to my face and tell me that it's a problem.
At a women's college in New England, where accusations of lesbianism were periodically leveled against roommates in the 1960s, the standard solution was to separate the accused by housing them in different dorms. We weren't really sure anything about her. We started following each other on social media and did see her posting a picture with a girl and saying, like, oh, like, I love you. It's been so long, like, happy anniversary.
I mean, when I found out, I saw it through Instagram. And at first, I wasn't really sure if she was gay, but I saw her kissing someone. So I was like, oh my God. I was like, my cousin, like, we were on vacation. And I was like, I think she's gay. And, like, of course, like, I never had that, like been with someone, like, you know, who's gay, living with someone. So, like, I didn't know what it was going to be like. I wasn't, not homophobic, but I was definitely like, wow, like, what is this going to be like? You know, of course, everyone's going to be nervous if you're not used to it. And I wasn't, so.
Something different. Like, I just never realized that I would have one, like a roommate that was gay, and it just never came to my head, I guess. But it's not like it's a big deal, though.
The first time inviting my girlfriend over to the dorm, I didn't exactly care, but she cared because she was very concerned about what my roommates thought of her and were very scared that they weren't gonna like her.
Jasmine and Eileen both met Alyssa, and I didn't get the opportunity to meet her yet, so I wasn't really sure who she was or anything about her, but I did hear about her and I did know of her. So, I mean, actually meeting her wasn't that big of a deal. We've become really close with Alyssa.
She first walked in the room and she was just staring at my pictures, and like, I felt like we were both analyzing each other. We were both staring like at each other, like being like, what, like seeing what it was gonna be like. But like after the first day, I felt like all the tension was gone. Like I feel like we both needed to like be in the same room, see how it felt. And then after that, like you get to know each other and you're like, why was I nervous? Like she's an awesome person. We like right now, we're all best friends. Like it's funny to think about how nervous I was and like how we both were to like now, cause we're like, oh my God, like this is nuts.
The first time I met Alyssa, I didn't really had time that much to like formally introduce myself, but you know, over the time, she's usually here, always here for the most part, but she's really cool. And so like, we all get along with her and she's really nice. So, I mean, I don't mind her being here. She's basically part of the family.
In recent years, harassment, violence, and other hate-motivated acts against lesbians and gay men have surfaced with alarming frequency on campuses across the country.
I play softball. I kind of didn't believe the stereotype at first because, I mean, there's basketball and soccer, and I really believe those sports are much more masculine considering the clothing they wear. I mean, we wear like jerseys and pants and stuff, but they're form-fitting to women, and basketball and soccer wears long basketball shorts with cut-off jerseys and just very masculine.
They maintain that women athletes would become man-like adopting masculine dress, talk, and mannerisms. In addition, they contended too much exercise would damage female reproductive capacity.
One of my friends on the soccer team says she's the only one.
My name is Sydney Ross. My sexual orientation is I love women. I was actually really nervous about coming out because I was joining the soccer team here and I didn't know how they would react, especially like living with my roommates who are on the soccer team. So I thought they were gonna be weird about it, but they were actually pretty cool. They didn't really care.
My name is Christina. I play softball. I didn't know I liked girls until about a month ago. I did tell my roommates. One of them is on the softball team. So she was just like, oh my God, I'm so happy for you. And the other one was just like, what? She's in like DG and stuff, but she like is like really cool about it.
LGBT students report less of a sense of community on campus than do heterosexual students.
One time, I was walking with my ex-girlfriend on campus, holding her hand, and these two girls were walking by, and they like tried to whisper, but they weren't really good at whispering. They're like, here, let's hold hands. And then they held each other's hand and were like laughing. So I automatically let go of my girlfriend's hand at the time, and I was like, it's 2015. I was like, it's 2015, like get over it.
I have never really felt like a label in my life.
Like I don't define her as gay because the more we hang out, she's just Taylor. You know, there's really no difference at all. Like she's just a girl who likes another girl. And you know, she's a friend and a roommate to me.
I feel like I'm more aware of, you know, gay pride, and like I see a lot of people who are now gay now, and like I can say I support that. And then I'm very like, I tell all my family and my friends, and I'm just like, I just say it like nonchalant, oh yeah, like they went to Pride. Like, whereas before I think I was more like, I didn't want to talk about that kind of stuff because I didn't know about it. And none of my friends are really gay at home. So like, I didn't know anything about it, but now that I do, I'm like more open about it.
It's not like, oh, you're gay, like we have to be best friends, or oh, you're gay, like, stay away from me. No, it's just like, oh, you're gay, well, cool, like, it's not that big of a deal. You only connect with people who you just connect with, not based off of their sexuality.